What's up, agents? It's Chase and Jay Miles, and I'm here with another video. I want to know, has anyone ever told you that you should focus on listings if you really want to build your real estate business? Well, I heard that day in and day out when I first got in real estate, and so what I want to do in this video is I want to tell you the pros and cons, or the advantages and disadvantages, of working with listings. And so I'm going to give you three for each so that you can know what you're getting yourself into if you do decide to become a listing agent. If this is your first time watching one of my videos, welcome. On my YouTube channel here, I like to give advice relating to actually working in real estate. I've been a real estate agent for many years now, and so I just like to share my knowledge and my experiences and things like that in hopes of inspiring someone or maybe helping you out along your actual real estate journey. So thank you for being here. Please go ahead and click the subscribe button because I would love to have you part of my YouTube community. So let's go ahead and get into the pros and cons of being a listing agent. All right, so one big advantage to working with listings or working with sellers is it gives you the opportunity to have your sign in the yard. And I know that may seem like an obvious thing, but what that's gonna do is not only just put your pretty face in the yard if you have your face on your sign, but it'll let buyers actually call you because it's gonna have your phone number on there, and that's gonna be a great way for you to get in buyer leads. Now, when you get these sign calls, you're gonna have to work with them and convert them and use your scripts and everything like that, but it's kinda like free publicity for buyers. And so that's the first advantage to taking on listings. Another advantage when it comes to the listing side is you get the cooperation of other brokers or other agents to sell the property for you. And so a lot of agents, especially the agents who work exclusively with buyers, they really like new listings because it gives them the opportunity to maybe sell that home to the buyer. And so instead of it just being you trying to sell that property alone, all the other agents out there with clients in the area are trying to sell it for you. And so that's another advantage of having listings. The third pro to having listings and working with sellers is it gives you an opportunity to market yourself and market your business. So when you do take on listings, of course you're going to be blasting them out everywhere. You're probably going to host open houses. You're going to get marketing materials made. And so this gives you a perfect opportunity to really market yourself and market your business. This is what's going to be seen from a lot of people. You're going to get seen and talked to by other sellers, maybe people in the neighborhood. Of course, your sign calls, but then also even through social media, people are going to be able to see that you're actually out here working and that you're producing. And so this is another reason why it's great to work with sellers, because you get to put that exposure of not only the property out there, but also yourself as a listing agent. Now is the time that I want to come over to the actual cons of working with sellers. Now, these shouldn't deter you, and I wouldn't let them deter you, but I do want to make you mindful of the cons that do exist. The first one is listings and sellers are way more of an investment than buyers. And you know, I know some people may look at this in a different light, but you're gonna spend a lot of money doing listings and working with sellers because you're going to be investing this money up front and hoping that the property actually sells. And so you could be in a situation where you've invested a lot of time and invested a lot of money into a property and then it doesn't sell. So you're just kind of out of luck at that point. But hopefully you won't run into that. But listings do require a lot more money up front, and I like to call them an investment up front to get the property sold. Next, another downside of working with sellers is that they can be a little difficult to get. And so if you're like me, where a lot of people your age don't own homes and a lot of people are still leasing, it's going to really come down to you networking and cold calling and doing all of those things to get listings. And so they can be a little bit more difficult to get than your average buyer or your average person looking to rent. Whenever listings and sellers are choosing brokers to hire to actually get their property sold, they take that very seriously. And it can come down to stupid stuff like commissions or, you know, who knows, but they can be a little bit more difficult to get, so just be prepared for that. Lastly, the last con that I want to present to you is that listings can require a lot more work. So with a listing, especially a listing that doesn't sell the first week, it can require a lot of work. I mean, we're talking all the marketing that you have to do, the open houses, maybe the door knocking that you're gonna do, and then all the stuff on the back end that we do to actually service the listing can take a lot more time, and it can be a lot more work than working with the buyer. You know, with the buyer, you're just going, unlocking a door, showing the properties, and hopefully writing a contract. But with listings, you have to put a lot of muscle behind them to actually get them sold for those listings that aren't so hot on the market. Now, this could include listings that are overpriced or distressed properties, listings that may not look that good or maybe in an area that not a lot of people want to live in. And so it could really take a lot of work to get some listings sold. But if you're up for the challenge, then I encourage you to definitely put in the time and effort that it takes to get these listings sold. I recorded a vlog video not too long ago. Well, it was kind of some months ago, but it's still on my channel here, where I was trying to sell a property and it was a disaster, but I ended up getting it sold. It wasn't the first day on the market type of sold, but I ended up getting it sold. And so they can require a lot more work. So just so you know that. So I hope this information has been helpful to you. I would love to keep this conversation going. So please leave me a note in the comments below, maybe about your experience working with sellers and working with listings, or if you prefer just to work with buyers, I'd love to know. And as always, give me a thumbs up if this information was informative, and please go ahead and subscribe to my channel, because I would love to have you a part of my real estate community here. So until next time, I'm Chasen J. Miles, and I will talk to you soon.